Hello everyone, and welcome to the Western Railroading Series. In this series of videos, we will take a look at some of the finest Class 1 railroading in the West, and visit some of the most famous locations and storied rail lines in the United States. We will travel from the deserts of Southern California, up through the Rocky Mountains, and even visit the famous Montana Railing before it is reabsorbed by BNSF. So sit back, relax, and enjoy some of the most incredible scenes American railroading can offer. In this final episode of the Western Railroading Series, we will take a look at BNSF's Northern Transcon on the western side of Moriah's Pass. We will follow trains from the division point at Whitefish, Montana, into the Montana Rockies surrounding Glacier National Park, staying at the famous trackside Izaak Walton Inn. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the spectacular scenery surrounding this former Great Northern Railroad. Our first train of the day is a loaded grain train departing Whitefish for points west. Following the grain train out of the yard, the Whitefish local is up next with two BNSF Jeeps for power. Up next at the Whitefish Amtrak station is an eastbound intermodal train coming from Seattle with 2 miles of international stacks from Asia.
Thank you.
With the locomotives reaching the east end of the yard, the train comes to a stop to change crews. Forty-five miles to the east, and we arrive at the base of Moriah's Pass in Essex, Montana, at the Izaak Walton Inn. This location hosts a small yard where helper operations for the pass are staged, and today it was being used to house work trains. Just east of the inn, the BNSF track geometry train surprises us, heading towards Whitefish. Over the next few hours at the inn, we will get a very good look at the yard operations happening here in Essex. In this first scene, the two helper locomotives are departing the yard to go tie on to an eastbound manifest. Our first road train at the inn is an eastbound empty grain train headed up Moriah's Pass as work crews shuffle around equipment to prepare for the arrival of a ballast train that has spent the day working on the tracks around Essex. With the MLW equipment in the clear, the BNSF 6715 ballast train backs into the yard. As the ballast train yards its consist, our next eastbound road freight, a manifest, heads up the pass.
control about 15 with stop now. We're
15 or stop.
After going around the Y, the work train power hooks up to the west end of the ballast cars. Next up, the Essex helper set heads east to tie on to the rear end of the manifest train that just passed by. Next up, the second work train arrives at Essex Yard to tie down for the night. The eastbound parade continues with the stack train that we saw at Whitefish, now with a fresh crew headed up Mariah's Pass.
Yeah.
More eastbound traffic is up next in the form of an autorack train with two BNSF GEs up front. With the autorack train stopped for traffic ahead, a westbound manifest descends the pass. With the autorack train getting underway, another westbound, this time a loaded crude oil train, descends Mariah's Pass headed for Whitefish. After helping the eastbound mixed freight up the pass, the Essex helper set returns to the yard. Next up, heading west, was the Amtrak Empire Builder departing the Essex, Montana station with the horn echoing through the mountains. Next up, we have an eastbound tanker train headed up the grade with some Canadian Pacific Power trailing. Next up, more Canadian Pacific Power shows up leading an eastbound grain train. The parade of Canadian Power continues with the next westbound stack train, with a CN engine trailing last. The final train of the night was an eastbound stack train with two BNSF GEs up front and one on the rear. The next morning and the last day of the western trip began with a westbound BNSF hopper train descending the pass behind two H2 painted Dash 9s. Up next, and closely following the hopper train, a loaded grain train descends the pass. With the main line clear of traffic for a little while, the two work trains, who were dumping ballast around the area yesterday, depart the yard to begin their day's work. As the work equipment continues to depart, a westbound stack train heads down the grade. Next up, we would see a parade of three eastbounds, the first of which was the Amtrak Empire Builder pulling in to his Essex station stop. The next eastbound was a mixed freight with two DC Gevos wide open tackling the grade. The third eastbound and our final train in Essex was an empty grain train.
BNSF detector, milepost 1170.3. Main 1, no defect. Repeat, no defect. Now headed back west towards Whitefish, we intercept an eastbound high priority stack train at Coram, Montana. Now back in Whitefish, we catch the BNSF geometry train that we saw yesterday coming back east with the 8319 still in the lead. After the geometry train's departure, a westbound international stack train arrives at the station for a crew change. After a couple of hours of preparing for the journey home tomorrow morning, we got back out to the east end of the Whitefish Yard where two eastbounds were preparing to depart. After stopping for a few minutes to reset its PTC, the eastbound intermodal departs as the manifest backs into Whitefish Yard to pick up a cut of cars. After both eastbounds got out of the way, Amtrak's westbound Empire Builder came into Whitefish, led by one of their new Siemens ALC-42 Charger locomotives in the Phase 6 paint scheme. The mountain backdrop in a bright pink sunset made for one of my favorite shots from Montana.
We caught up with the train one more time as it departed its station stop at Whitefish. One thing that was really cool for me about this train was that on my June 2021 road trip 1 year ago, I caught this engine being delivered. It was really cool now to see it in revenue service leading a long-distance train. After the Empire Builder cleared the station, we set up for our final train of the Western Railroading Series, a westbound loaded oil train arriving at the Whitefish Depot for a crew change. As we say goodbye to Montana, I want to thank you for watching the Western Railroading Series and hope you enjoyed following along and catching some of the coolest trains that the West has to offer.